And as I will be in Nashville on the 15th to 15th, 16th, and 17th, on the 16th and 17th, I'm teaching Fraktur and it's flourishing. So I thought it would be nice for you to see the word Nashville written Fraktur with some of that historical flourishing. Obviously, I'm using my lining template. I already started ruling up the lines. So they're 12 mil apart. I'm going to rule some verticals as well because I think it's nice to have the verticals to give you a sense of space. But I only need every other. And you can see there's a little mark here that indicates every other one, so I don't have to count it. But Fraktur is generally written with the nib at either 45 or 60 degrees. I am going to 45. 45. I'm behind it. There is my 45 there. I'm just going to drop that on the side of the. Side of the pad. Actually, move that up a little bit more. And there's a 45 over here. If I get those vertical, then that tells me that that's my 45 degree angle. So I'm again, little line to line. Skipping every other one. Too many lines. Oh, right. Get to some writing. I'm using Monteverde copper noir ink, but I've thinned it down a little bit. I'm going to use a Speedball and a just Gillott 303. So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to tear this out of the pad now that I've ruled it up because I'm going to need to turn the sheet as I'm producing flourishes. There are lots of different letters that I could use this. Lots of different types of pens. Oh, I was going to start up here, but I realized that I also need more space underneath, so start a little bit lower down. And you can see I'm really sort of painting with the brush, the nib. And I'm not just writing, I'm using a little bit of pressure and release. I already have in my head what I'm planning to do because of the types of flourishes I need. Swap to the 03 now. I'm going to have to use muscular movement for this. Absolutely. There. And I'm using some, not just using some standard Fraktur flourishes, I'm also using some tendril flourishing and some cadell flourishing. As you can see, I'm really working with the lighter line. Build the cadell. So these are false cadells, not true cadells. If they were true cadells, then it would all be done in one line. Now you can see I'm crossing these lines, even though they have a little bit of weight to them. Might go against something you've been told, which is two thick strokes can't cross each other. Two thick strokes can cross each other, they just can't cross each other at their thickest point. No, I hadn't planned to do that. I'd actually planned to start here, but once I saw the top of the S, I thought, oh, I can just add that in right there. And then this is some really typical, really standard flourishing practice.
Oh.
also have to do it on the cell, but doubling it up, that's why I've left this much space. You know, I've sort of planned quite a lot of this well beforehand. Also, I'm moving the end to the middle of the page, so I actually have some space to, I'm not off the edge of the thing, of the piece of paper. That's a real typical sort of fractal version. I'm going to try and correct this. My hand touched the edge of the page as I was producing the flourish. The structure of the flourish is there. Just wobbled a little bit. And I'm kind of throwing in some 18th century English round hand shapes just to balance that out a little bit better. And let's link these two. And similarly, link this. And we can add some balancing strokes, not too close to the letters. You don't want them to be misconstrued. If you had an U as an umlaut, and flourishes off the N, they didn't add them to the second downstroke. And the thing to note is, I'm not rushing, really taking my time with the flourish get away with me. And I've only touched that because I needed to get the going. And there is that really lovely over the top decorative fraktur with its attendant flourishing. Quite a lot of historical structure in there. So this is some of what I will be teaching at the workshop in Nashville on March 16th, 17th. And I hope to see you.